Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, and welcome back to this next video. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the first and the second messenger. Whenever you study the cell signaling, you will come across these two terms, the first messengers and the second messenger. So in this video, I'm going to focus on the first and the second messengers on the perspective of the cell signaling. So the first thing we are going to discuss is what are the first messengers. These first messengers, they are extracellular signaling molecules, and they are also known as the ligands. What they do is that they are going to bind to their respective receptors, which are located on the surface of the cells. So if these extracellular signals are going to bind on the receptors on the surface of the cells, therefore they are extracellular substances. What I mean by this is that they are not able to cross the cell membrane. So they are going to convey their message from the extracellular to the intracellular of the cell with the help of these receptors. Once these extracellular signals, they bind to their respective receptors, they are able to initiate intracellular activities, or they are going to initiate changes within the cell. Most of the time, these changes, they are changes in the gene expression. Now, these first messengers, they are very diverse, they can be like environmental factors. They can be like different hormones, for example, the epinephrine. They can be neurotransmitters, for example, the dopamine. They can be peptides, or they can be proteins. What I mean by this is that the first messenger are a very diverse group of the molecules. And why they are called as the first messenger? Because these are the ones that are going to start the cell signaling pathway in a cell. Now, as I've told you that these extracellular signals or these first messengers, they are going to bind to their receptors. So there are different kinds of the receptors to receive these signals from the first messengers. For example, one of the important types of the receptor that you see on the surface of the cells, they are ion channels. You can have the intracellular receptors, and these intracellular receptors, most of the time, they are for the hydrophobic signals. They can be the G protein coupled receptors. There can be single pass transmembrane receptors. What I mean by this is that there are a variety of the extracellular signals, and there are a variety of the receptors, except this one, this intracellular receptor, because they are for the hydrophobic ligands. So they are present inside the cell and not on the surface of the cell. But these ion channels, these G protein coupled receptors, these single pass transmembrane receptors, all of these, they are present on the surface of the cell to receive these extracellular signals. What these first messenger do is that they help the organism to receive information from the outside world. Because of the hydrophilic nature of these first messenger, in most of the cases, they are not able to enter into the cell. Thereby, they are using the receptors on the surface of the cell to communicate their message to the interior of the cell. So these are first messenger. In the next video, I'll be talking on the second messengers and then on the differences between the first and the second messenger. So if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button and share it with your friends.